I have heard of the dead lying in heaps, but never saw it till this battle.
September 17th, 1862, the day before my birthday, is known as the bloodiest single day in American history, with an estimated 23,100 casualties.
Spring and summer of 1862 saw a string of Confederate victories in Virginia.
This is before my birthday!
A small Confederate force commanded by Major General Thomas J. Stonewall Jackson defeated three small Union commands in the Shenandoah Valley during the month of May and June, threatening the security of Washington. Abraham Lincoln commanded that these three commands be consolidated into the Army of Virginia.
I command that these three commands be consolidated into the Army of Virginia. And I know that those of you who have no belly buttons are aliens.
The Army of Potomac was driven back from the Confederate capital of Richmond by the Confederate Army of Northern Virginia during the 7 days' battles in early summer. The federal government decided to withdraw the Army of the Potomac and join it with the Army of Virginia. Before they could, Lee struck and defeated the Army of Virginia in late August at the Battle of Second Bull Run, 35 miles south of the Union capital, but Lee was in trouble.
I shall march north of Washington, into Maryland, to draw the Union troops out of their entrenchments there. I need rations, troops, and ammo, and hopefully, while I am there, I can convince the people of Maryland to come to the Confederate side.
Longstreet, take your three divisions and head towards Hagerstown, Maryland. Stonewall, take your six divisions and converge on Harper's Ferry. Longmeat and Stonewall, split!
Precious plans! The plans! I'll show these to McClellan! Yes! Yes! The precious plans!
On my niece's birthday! He knows! He knows!
Monsieur Lee, I've seen it to be. Jackson has won. His battle is done. The Union can sit that up there big.
McClellan's cautious behavior, like that of a ninja, causes me to stand and fight. He will not roundhouse kick me this time. I've only got 19,000 men. He's got twice as much, but Fico! I remain!
McClellan waited until the evening of the 16th to move forward and make his final arrangements. He launched a series of uncoordinated attacks at the Confederates' left, then the center, and finally the right. Hoorah! Longstreet took the right of the line.
And Jackson's troops, as they arrived, took the left.
Union General Burnside delayed his attack on the Confederate right, so Lee was able to shift forces from the area to oppose the assaults of Union troops led by Generals Hooker, Mansfield, and Sumner. General Joseph Hooker's command led the first Union assault. Then General Joseph Mansfield's soldiers attacked, followed by General Edwin Sumner's men as McClellan's plan broke down into a series of uncoordinated Union advances. Savage, incomparable combat raged across the cornfield, Eastwoods, Westwoods, and the sunken road as Lee shifted his men to withstand each of the Union thrusts. After fighting for over 8 hours, the Confederates were pushed back but not broken. However, over 15,000 soldiers were killed or wounded.
As Hooker's, Mansfield, and Sumner's assaults were being made on the sunken road, General Ambrose Burnside opened his attack on the Confederate right 1.5 miles to the south. His first goal was to capture the stone bridge that would later bear his name. A small Confederate force, positioned on higher ground, was able to delay Burnside for 3 hours. Ambrose Powell Hill's division arrived at the end of a forced march from Harper's Ferry and delivered a crushing counterattack, saving Lee's right.
Exact casualties for the Battle of Antietam have never been properly calculated due to cannibalism, but it is estimated that the Union lost 12,410 men and the Confederates lost 11,172.
Drink and it will never be enough, so give them blood, blood, blood. Grab a glass because the there's going to be a flood.
This is a glorious birthday present.
Moon on September 18th, 1862.
Fico!
Sir, a counterattack is impossible.
Shut up, Longmeat. Fico!
Victory is impossible.
You know nothing about victory, Stoneball. Fico!
Oh, really? Don't you remember the fairy?
I thought that was just the absinthe. Fico!
Don't do drugs! Sir, we have to pull out.
That's what she said. Lady Liberty, I mean.
Sir, we can get back alive if we leave now.
Well, I guess I should celebrate. To Virginia!
The battle was a tactical draw, but it was a strategic victory for the Union. The British and the French became hesitant to publicly support the slaveholding Confederate states.
Publicly, I will not publicly support the Confederacy. Publicly.
The Confederacy has lost my public support, meaning I shall no longer publicly support them. Publicly.
It was the improvement in the North's military fortunes that Lincoln had been waiting for to announce the Emancipation Proclamation.
That, on the first day of January, in the year of our Lord, 1863, all persons held as slaves within any state or designated part of a state, the people whereof shall then be in rebellion against the United States, shall be thenceforward and forever free.
This shifted the point of the war from preserving the Union to freeing the slaves. Furthermore, the victory made people think that the North was doing better in the war, which may have helped elections for the Republican Party in 1862. Many considered it the turning point of the war for the North. Alas, alas, alas.
The federal government decided to withdraw the Army of the Potomac.
The Confederacy has lost my public support, meaning I shall no longer...
A small Confederate force commanded by Major General Thomas J. Stonewall Jackson defeated three small units command...
Let the bodies hit the floor, let the bodies hit the floor, let the bodies hit the floor, let the bodies hit the...
I need troops, rations, and ammo. 2-1. Longstreet, take your 3 divisions and head towards Hagerstown, Maryland. Stonewall, take your 6 divisions and converge on Harper's Ferry. Stone meet and...
Danny, no! Don't use that one.
Gathered in their masses, just like witches at black masses. Evil minds that plot destruction, sorcerer of death's construction. In the fields of bodies burning, as the war machine keeps turning. Hatred to mankind, poisoning their brainwashed minds.